everybody, welcome back to my let's play of Drawn the Painted Tower, part 2. Let's continue on where we left off. And I don't know, I was going to say this right before the dialogue, little cutscene before the at the end of the last episode, but do you guys understand what I mean about like the music and like the art style? Isn't it just like so cute? And even the voice acting isn't all that bad so far. So, like, I really enjoyed this when I first played it. So anyway, let's continue. So this is where we left off. So we're just going to go up the stairs. Alrighty then. Alright. It's a hammer, I'm sure. Yep. Alright. Journal entry. Witch doctor. Wand, feathers, beads, wooden staff, dragonflies, and butterflies, and other little things. I've always wanted to meet a real witch doctor. Franklin says there's no such thing, but I believe in magic and sorcery. Maybe I'll put some shrunken heads hiding in the scene. It's really hard to read some of this. This should be a fun painting, Iris. Oh, look at that. Let's go back for one quick second, though. Oh, so I can't do anything. All right. Whoa, kablam! Now the shifting sands hide the key to the painting. Oh, so like really got messed up over here. Alright. A large puddle of water. Look at that. That seems important. That was from before. The wall's been cracked. Let's hammer it some more. We got a window shard. How that ended up behind broken wall, I don't know, but... painting covers the floor. Shovel. Oh, I know what we have to do. Okay. Several pieces on the window appear to be missing. That's nice. Let's go up. Dear Franklin, I worry about the coming storm. I have always been afraid of the thunder. Maybe because of that night long ago. But I know you will always protect me. Thank you, Iris. P.S. Remember to come and see the play. I have been hard at work on the characters. Iris loves tree. That's nice. Iris standing in front of a giant tree. Gonna need that. Gonna need that. Gonna need that. No. Oop. Trying to kill me. Wonder where that came from. Was another piece of window shard, another window shard, a stone star, and a flickering candle. A moon made of silver? Need that. There's a star-shaped recess at the top of the door. I'm gonna put this star-shaped. They lit up. A heart-shaped hole has appeared. What I wanted. It tells me it needs to look like this. Yes, yes. So far, so good. Put that there. Okay, so we're missing something. Oh, right there. Jesus. I'm an idiot. All right. Boop, 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 boop. Okay, I guess we're missing another piece. Mm-hmm. Right there. Again, let me say that I'm an idiot. All right. Put this up here. There we go. Light shines through the window. X marks the spot, except it's an arrow this time. Canvas fragment. Okay. The painting is covered with soot. So what I did was I put the rag into the water, and then it became a wet rag. Pretty sure you're not supposed to do this to actual paintings. Don't use water to wipe it down, but what do I know? Okay. Wasn't there a doctor in here before the explosion? Yes, there was. What was that? The tower has gone crazy? My wand is gone. My cauldron is cold. I feel powerful magic in the tower. Okay, you gonna do anything about that? Ceramic pot, a stone pot. Can I bust it like I did that one? Yes. Boop, boop. Nothing like, you know, some, you know, destruction. Alright, what did all... I got some netting, a shrunken head, a partial net, and another shrunken head. Hey, we got a net. Alright. Masks and shrunken heads adorn the shelf. Uh-huh. Well, I got a shrunken head. Yeah. There you go. Got a stick. A magic staff. Okay. The cauldron is cold. I can't create a potion with no heat. Oh, okay. Well, thanks for that, but a bubbling cauldron does me no good with no wand to use it on. Now does it? Okay, well, take your freaking magic staff back, dude. I need 3 magic pieces to create the wand. Feathers, beads, and a staff. They should be around here somewhere. Oh. Okay. Oh, come on. Boop. No, I guess you don't want that one. Middle one? Woo! Thanks! You're welcome, I guess. So I don't... Rough. Alright, I guess you want your teeth. Ah, you saved me twice now. I found the magic beans in the pot. They're yours. Thank you. The loud guy is missing something. Oh, sorry. What? I can't hear what you're saying. Okay, well then take a wooden ear. My ear! All I have to thank you is this magic feather. Okay. Thank you. I'll put that in it. In it. In it. No. Okay. Can you... Items used for magic. You have the 3 magic items for the wand. Quickly, place them in the spell circles. Okay. Take them. They're yours, man. Nifty. Powerful magic is at work here. If you can bring me the thistle, leaf, sunflower, butterfly, dragonfly, and a bee, I can help you on your quest. You'll need to find them somewhere else. Okay. The only other place we've been that we can go, really, is the other painting. And if you remember, there was stuff. Okay, we're gonna get our net. Bam. Oopsie. Oh, I did get the bee. Oh, perfect. Butterfly, dragonfly, leaf. I need a sunflower. I feel this. Oh, there we go. Did I get everything? I think I got everything. We'll see. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Recipe for success. Ooh. The potion of growth is an old family recipe. It combines the prepared ingredients with the creatures of flight. It will need time to reach full potency, though, so we have to hurry. Okay. This is glowing. Before the recipe is revealed, leaf, thistle, and sunflower must all be prepared. Okay. You can have... Need something sharp to prepare this, so we... Boop. Okay. Thistle, you can have that. Smush, 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 smush. That's nice. And then sunflower. Pluck, 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 pluck. I was saying pluck, not the other word. Recipe A. A small vial, low on the shelf. After powder, the color of night. A bowl of cut leaves in the middle before a flower of light. A small vial on the low on the shelf. After powder, the color of night. So, color powder of night, small vial. A bowl of cut leaves in the middle before a flower of light. Uh-huh. So we're going to put that. A vial low on the shelf. That one. Ugh, gosh. A small vial low on the shelf. After. Oh, my bad. A bowl of cut leaves. After. I read that wrong. I mean, you can't really have a middle when there's only four things. A small vial low on the shelf. Maybe that one. Who knows? I swear to goodness gravy. There's no other vial, is there? There's that, but that says low on the shelf. Leaf in the middle, and then flower. There we go. I prepared a potion prepared to the doctor it goes. Just part of the spell for the potion of growth. Look, guys, I never said I could read properly, alright? Alright, so... The potion of growth is an old family recipe. Okay, so we just need to give it to him. Same thing. There you go. The potion of growth. Time to reach full potency. We have to hurry. Yep. Oh. You want these now? Butterfly. Take that too. You know, just because he turned everything into, like, really sparkly glitter doesn't mean that he didn't just kill, like, three bugs. The growth potion now needs to gain strength. It will take some time. In the interim, you'll need this heart to reach the upper floors.
Oh.
Remember, if magic is needed, you only need to find me. Iris is a special girl, and one day will rule the kingdom, so she must be saved. Okay. I'm gonna go back. Right, I'm gonna go back. Alright. We're gonna just go forward then. And then back up here. And then we're gonna put the heart in the little heart-shaped slot. And we got needle and thread. Okay. Let's go forward.
The tower is cursed and indeed dangerous to us all. The bell is fallen, taking the bridge with it. The witch doctor was right. Not only is Iris held prisoner at the top, but traps have been laid for anyone attempting to save her. But you must continue on. You must find a way to the top. Quickly.
Whoops. Alright, so this is it for this episode. I will see you in the next one. I hope everyone has a good day, and I'll see you later.